हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर न्यू वीडियो। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉमन गैसेस दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन अ माइंड। वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस, व्हाट शुड बी द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द गैस एंड हाउ इट अफेक्ट्स द वर्कर्स विच आर वर्किंग इन साइड द माइंड। ओके, सो इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस मेनली अबाउट ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑन नेक्स्ट वीडियोज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द अदर गैसेज दैट आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द माइंड। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद ऑक्सीजन। So guys, as we know, oxygen is a very vital element which is present in the atmosphere and which is very essential for the survival of human beings and animals. So first, let's look about its physical properties. Now coming to the first point, oxygen is colorless, okay? It's tasteless, it is slightly soluble in water. Okay, you have to remember these points. Coming to the next point, the specific gravity of oxygen is 1.1, okay? The specific gravity of oxygen is 1.1 and it is slightly heavier than air, okay? And its specific gravity is 1.1, okay? So here I have used a term specific gravity. So talking about the specific gravity of a gas, it refers to the weight of an given volume of gas compared with the weight of an equal volume of air at the same pressure and temperature. Okay, I repeat it once again. Specific gravity of gas, it refers to the weight of an given volume of gas compared with the weight of an equal volume of air at the same temperature and pressure. So the specific gravity of air is 1.1, and that means 100 volume of water at 20 degrees Celsius dissolves about 3 volume of oxygen. Okay, 100 volume of water at 20 degrees Celsius dissolves about 3 volume of oxygen. So these were the physical properties of oxygen. Now coming to the next point, that is how oxygen is consumed in a mine. Okay, so the first point is breathing by persons. Breathing by person, that means if a worker is working in a mine, he will inhale the oxygen and it will lead to the reduction of oxygen level, okay, in the atmosphere. Next point is slow oxidation of coal and other carbonaceous material. Oxidation of coal and other carbonaceous material also lead to the reduction of concentration level of oxygen in atmosphere. Next point is burning of flame safety lamp. Okay, talking about the coal mines, we use flame safety lamps. So in burning of flame safety lamp, we use oxygen. Oxygen is needed. So in that case, it led to the reduction of oxygen level. And in talking about in non-coal mine, acetylene lamps or naked lights are used. So in that case also, oxygen is needed. Now coming to the next point, decay of timber by fungus growth. So here timber is used for supporting the roof, and for the decay of timber by fungus, it also needs oxygen. So in these scenarios, in these cases, oxygen is consumed, which led to the reduction of concentration of oxygen level in atmosphere inside the mines. So this accounts for the diminished percentage of oxygen in the return air of a mine. Talking about another reason is the mine gases given off from coal and adjacent strata. They also reduce the overall oxygen percentage in the air. Now these are some important points which you have to keep in your mind. The first one is each 1% reduction in the oxygen results in about 30% less light from oil lamps. This means if the oxygen level will drop, if the oxygen level drops by 1%, then the light from oil lamps will reduce to about 30%. Okay. Now talking about the next point, oil lamps is extinguished when the oxygen percentage falls to about 17.5%. Okay, so if the oxygen level goes to 17.5%, then the oil lamps get extinguished. Okay, now I'm talking here, it is a very important point, you have to keep this in your mind, that mine air should contain minimum 19% of oxygen. Okay, it is also included in the mining laws that the mine air should contain a minimum 19% of oxygen. This value, you have to keep this in your mind, minimum 19% of oxygen should be needed inside a mine. Okay, Now coming to the next point, acetylene lamp can burn even when the oxygen percentage is as low as 12 to 13%, and it is not a good indicator for detecting oxygen deficiency. See, human beings can survive in an atmosphere containing as low as 15% oxygen, but in mines 19% oxygen is required, minimum 19% oxygen is required, but the acetylene lamp can even burn in 12 to 13% of oxygen. So it is a not good conductor, not good indicator for detecting the oxygen. Okay, so if there will be oxygen deficiency, so acetylene lamp can even burn in 12 to 13%. So if there will be 15% or 17% oxygen level, then it will burn. So but the minimum air that should be contained in a mine is 19%. So acetylene lamp is generally not a good indicator to detect the oxygen deficiency. Now talking about next point, the inhalation of pure oxygen under normal pressure for a limited period of up to 6 hours has no harmful effect. Okay, means if you are consuming, if you are inhaling the pure oxygen for 6 hours, then it will under normal pressure, then it will have no harmful effect on your body. Okay, but in deep mines, that is 1000 to 1500 deep mines, the air pressure is about 15% more than at the surface. Okay, comparing with the surface, in deep mines the air pressure is 15% more than the surface, but the human breathing is not normally affected by this extra pressure. Okay, so this was the today's video about oxygen. I hope you like this video. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep learning. Thank you.